And we are back in, okay, before I continue, let me first introduce the show. The show is called Yap, in case you've just joined us. Reliable nonsense. Okay. Whenever I say that, man, I feel weird, man. Like, really, I'm doing a show called nonsense. Okay, but I'm always here Monday to Friday, 8 up to 8:30. Which again, so, my name is Tumusiime. That's it, really. So before we went for the break, we're still talking about the nonsense that is coming out of faith and religion. And you know, whenever I say these things, people like remnants, for them, they take it personally. Like when you say something about the remnants, the stupidity of Mbonye, and that thief boy with a receding hairline, they think that you're attacking them. No, I'm not even attacking Mbonye. Mbonye can die and somebody else will do it. The problem is not really with Mbonye. Days before Mbonye came, there was a man called Chibwetere. He locked up a few people and burnt them. After Chibwetere, there was another person. Even if you had to shoot Mbonye today, this girl probably will take over. So at the end of the day, the stupidity is not, we are not attacking Mbonye as a person. I don't have a problem with Mbonye. I just have a problem with being volunteering to be stupid, to go against the most basic common sense. And like I said, if Mbonye was not perfect, I understand that you can go to his church. I don't even know if it's a church or a fellowship, because Ruyonga comes and says, coming to you live from heaven. Then I nyabu na nade waka. What do you have a Muguru not in your border? Can you order for safe border and Muguru? You're in heaven, but they can snatch your phone out child on now around that place. Ryonga, I know that rap is one of the hardest genres and you're broke, but come on, brah. You're too old for this embarrassment. Coming to you live from heaven. Hmm? Then there's a time they talk to that boy, he's the one who does the production of that place. You know, they talked to him and then Mbonye was on stage. Then they put glittering effects. I can do that in 2 minutes. Then they said that God descended upon him. If God was to descend upon earth, he would maybe come in my body. Because they seem wiser. But Mbonye looks so weird, man. He looks like a... okay, that's a person at below the belt. But you know, I how can someone come and say this story? And you people are thinking that this is okay and you glorify this nonsense. This stupidity, it would be easy to ignore, but it's wrong because it plays into the mindset of the African person. That's why I'm saying that I talk about this, not because of money, not because of that, but there's this willingness of black people to just be stupid. I just don't even know why. Every time you watch, we are just easy to walk over. Someone comes and he tells you that Boda people took him and drank your blood. You know, if at least they had lied to us in Agamba, they were Boda Boda 2010, we'd be like, what? Because at least there's Kaihura who was leading Boda Boda 2010 with those gangs. You see that some people say that's not true, but at least we can say there was Boda Boda 2010 with Kitata. Boda Boda people drinking blood? You know, this story, me, I would have thought that maybe they're going to rape her. Well, that's what Boda Boda people are, most time, sometimes do. I don't know the ones who are bad, not all of them, of course. She drank your blood? And then she told us they're performing a ritual. And then they were done with the ritual, then they ran away. First think about that. There are no recuperation, no one even attacked them. Jesus could not even beat them. At least Jesus Christ, man, yo, man. But somehow this makes sense. You're just volunteering to be dimwits. Come on, man. You can go to a church, but you can disagree with a pastor. It's like if you're in love. You can love a woman, but still say she's short. You know, if you fall in love with Vinka, I mean, you love her. But once in a while, you can look at her and know she looks like a man. You know, but now if you fall in love with Vinka and you're like, I know Kavina, love is blind, but you're just stupid. You can fall in love with Catherine Kusasira. That's okay. But now you cannot start getting bad ideas of lifting her up. Man, come on, man. That's about 5 times. Love her, but just shake hands. Don't commit yourself to lifting 25 tons, you know, of fossil. You can fall in love with like Don Zella, but you have to always use protection. Because the moment you go in as a headmaster, mama, You just get whooping cough, diarrhea, marasmus, dysentery, HTD. Even AIDS will be the weakest of the disease that you contract. You can fall in love with Andrew Mwenda. We accept, yes, it's love, it happens.
But once in a while, you can just wear headsets in the house so that when he talks, you don't listen. All I'm trying to say is that you can like someone or you can be part of something, but you don't have to tolerate every stupidity that comes from there.
You can be in NRM,
but now you don't have to be like Bebe Cool, kneel down, ask Museveni, do you want to susu, can I carry you, bichi bichi. Like, no.
You can be supporting Bobby Wine, but you can still know that that boy's brain likes weed more than leadership.
At first it was Mbonye, people were cursing, but now people were gabbling. What you saying? Like, all I'm trying to say is there has never been anything wrong with being part of something, but you can still see when it passes common sense.
That's why I like some people who are my friends, who I thought had been lost. Okay. Then when Stella Nyanzi showed us two purples, I don't think Sarah Nyanzi should have showed us two breasts. That's too much. One breast was enough. The breast is bigger than Spice Diana. But people were like, okay, we support you. We know you are angry, but you can't be. At least if you had breasts like for Fabiola or Flavia Tumusiime.
Yeah. If Flavia should join the police in the way I am, some women are lost, man. You be looking at that and you don't want to protest naked. What's wrong with you? Aren't you suppressed by the NRM regime? We are and show us.
So what I'm trying to say is, like, you can support Elvis.
I don't understand why anyone would support a person like that, because to me he's hopeless. Like, I have seen some con artists.
Very soon he's going to start asking you for money to process national IDs. And passports, you know, but you don't have to believe all this crap. Let me read some comments about this story before I lose my mind. Because on social media, some people support him, others don't. So there is Musa Abbas. You are paid to talk stupidity, but you need to repent and accept the creator who created you, and you are the one who made you from the spam and wrote spam with an A. You are just spamming your email, and is it for you the way you are pasted? You know, I don't know why people abata manje luzungu banyiga nyo. Then there is Gamukosa about what you're still breathing, but you can't differentiate who God is from Mbonye. Humans can't be compared with God. Period. The next time you try to die, you won't come back because Mbonye will be dead just like you did. The Samanya Teresa, repent, repent for worshiping mortal man in place of God the Almighty. Then there is, Mbamizo Emmanuel. This type of speaking, as if there is some alcohol in the drink. There's Richard Mukasa. Most pastors and prophets use fallen angels who call themselves Bachwezi and Kundalini. Hey, Richard, I call him Bachwezi. How did you know those things? This I've never had Kundalini. They are also they also conjure marine spirits. They cause hallucinations and out-of-body experiences. They also perform miracles. This woman was deceived by demons. She now worships a human being as a god. There's James Owana. The irony of not being religious and yet the belief seems idolatry more than anything. Yeah. So I think at the end of the day you can see that, you know, remnants. I don't know if there's anything that I cannot save you, because you really need saving, man. But looking at you, every remnant I've come across is an extremist. Although I have like 3 minutes I want to bang, but you know, winner, when I just, hey, man, those are as if they tell me to watch two kisses in Bonnie's shoes, I will even swallow the shoe, man. Why you gonna kind of hips where got him? Nekangama to kissing a papa. I'll be like, I'll swallow the shoe and the stocking. I say, Papa, do you want us to kiss your underwear? As long as that gets me that girl. There are 3 girls at Mbonye who I see and I have sexual dysfunction. But when I see them, I feel, oh, I'm too good to ya. Anyway, I just go to your live analysis. We are here Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Please, thanks for always tuning in. My name is Tumusiime. Until tomorrow, have a blessed night.